AM60 CKCL 658 with Alan Jackson's classic Dallas. Mike Trenholme's in the CKCL newsroom, but I'm back with Old Lonely, the Maytag Repairman. Actor Gordon Jump is in our studio, and he'll be here at 7:05.
You call me.
Charles, minus a 5 degrees, CKCL weather anytime at 893-1140. 7:05, I'm Mike Trenholme on CKCL, your first source for local news.
Baby, if you've ever wondered whatever became of me, I'm living on the air in Cincinnati, Cincinnati WKRP. Got kind of tired of packing and unpacking, town to town, up and down the dial.
Signature jingle from the world's most famous radio station, WKRP in Cincinnati, the station manager of which was Arthur Carlson, actor Gordon Jump, Old Lonely, the Maytag Repairman, is in Truro. Gordon, welcome to the hub of Nova Scotia.
Thank you, Dave. It's fun to be with you.
Well, I'll tell you, we are absolutely thrilled that you're in our studio this morning. That jingle from KRP... any idea who it's referring to? Any particular member of the cast?
I think it was Gary Sandy, the one who played Andy Travis. He was up and down the dial. And the only one in the cast that had a love interest outside of me and Carmen.
Well, okay. You know, you've gone from the company of the world's craziest radio station staff to being one of the world's loneliest people.
Yeah, wasn't an easy transition, but I've survived it.
Okay, it must be nice for you to be in the company of somebody. How ironic it's in a radio station.
It is, and how nice it is to come back to sort of my roots, because I came out of broadcasting. They didn't know that when they hired me for WKRP, but I and Howard Hessman, Richard Sanders, who played Les Nessman, and also Gary Sandy, all had backgrounds in radio. Nobody checked that out.
Was it ever your dream as a young broadcaster to be a station manager someday?
No, never was. It was always my dream as a young broadcaster to get out of the business and become an actor.
Well, you made a great transition to that one, that's for sure. Arthur Carlson, was he ever busy? He always seemed to be thinking of fishing, if I remember correctly.
Arthur Carlson was a man who was in a job that he really didn't want to have, but that was his means of existence, and so he persevered. Going to work for him in the morning was trying to figure out which one of his toys he was going to play with throughout the day. He was a leader by default, I think. But he loved the people that he worked with.
Well, folks, Gordon Jump is with us for this entire half hour, and coming up in just a moment or two, we're going to have the sports, and then we're going to have a Maytag update with Gordon Jump, who, by the way, you will have the opportunity to meet later this morning. We'll tell you more about that when we return. Right now, from Canada's western provinces, Alberta gave us Terry Clark, When Boy Meets Girl, from today's country hits and yesterday's favorite. Hill today, Gordon Jump is with us in the studio this morning. Bet you didn't know we had subways in Nova Scotia.
No, I didn't know you had subways in Nova Scotia. That's getting down there.
Bible Hill is pretty unique with their subway in this province. Busy night last night in sports, Gordon. Maybe you'd like to fill us in as to what happened.
Oh, golly, yeah. Here's sports course. Nova Scotia Senior Hockey League Finals. Truro 10, Kentville 3. Now, Truro leads the series 3-0 with game 4 in Truro on Saturday evening. In the National Hockey League, the scores look like this. Montreal 4, Boston 3, Pittsburgh 3, Florida 2, Dallas 3, Anaheim 1. Those Ducks can't seem to get out of the pond. Colorado 8 and San Jose 3. New Jersey and St. Louis tied at 4-4. They couldn't seem to win anything down there, but they had fun trying. In the NBA, Denver beat the Vancouver Grizzlies.
Again,
did that.
Always seems to happen, doesn't it?
Yep. Want to look at the weather?
We're going to. No, well, sure. Yeah, might as well. People are waking up every minute in radio.
That's true. Weather for central Nova Scotia today is going to be sunny, windy, and cold. What's new? With a high of minus 2. Tonight we're going to be clear with a low of minus 9. Expected flurries on Saturday with a high of minus 1.
And it's minus 4
right now. Can't get our buns out of the freezer, can we?
IGA supermarkets have sent me here to Italy for the ultimate...
Cookies and activity sheets are free at Funnyland in downtown Truro.
AM60 CKCL, we're at 7:15 on the sunshine morning. It's even brighter for us because the big guy is here. Actor Gordon Chump, Arthur Carlson, station manager of WKRP, is better known these days as Old Lonely, the Maytag Repairman. Hope you're not too lonely this morning.
Oh, gosh, no, Dave. This is great. It's fun to be at least sitting somewhere talking to someone, and this is really fun.
Old Lonely is one of the most famous series of television commercials ever made. It's been running since 1967. Jesse White was the original.
21 years, Dave, did that.
He retired. I suppose he calls you these days just to find some companionship, doesn't he?
He wants me to, you know, lend him golf balls and wants to borrow my putter on occasion, but I don't know.
Is life ever exciting for Old Lonely?
It is at times. Something, you know, the anticipation of something, it used to be exciting, but nobody really ever calls. Nobody to talk to there in the office, and the dog sleeps all the time.
Tell us about Newton. He's new to the series.
What can I tell? Well, he's actually the only thing in the office that needs fixing.
What, of the Old Lonely commercials that you have done so far, do you have a favorite?
Oh, yeah, the very first one that I did.
Oh, that's the contract one.
that's the contract one, where I hop on my bicycle and go through rain, hail, sleet, and snow to fix a hot dog for myself for lunch. The only thing you get to fix is lunch.
How many appearances does Old Lonely make in the run of a year? It must be a busy schedule for you.
It has become very busy, David. Maytag has found that this has proved to be quite advantageous to them. Mm-hmm. I'm not totally sure why, but they have me out and about now at least 10 days out of every month. So with the exception of December, they give me Christmas off.
You get to meet an awful lot of folks who does it surprise you that people are just still dying to meet you and still want to talk about KRP, but they must now be coming to you with Old Lonely stories?
It's very gratifying, to be very honest with you, and almost overwhelming. People have genuinely appreciated the humor that we've brought to them through WKRP. I'm amazed, particularly in Canada, how well that show has been received. We have some of the most ardent fans through the Canadian market that you can find anywhere in the world. People coming up to me all these past 3 or 4 days, telling me how much they enjoy the show, how they like the commercials for Maytag. I never expected in my life to receive that kind of warmth and acceptance from a group of people. It's really humbling.
Well, I'll tell you, people may be surprised to find out that they can meet you today. You're going to be at the Warehouse Outlet at the corner of Glenwood and Willow.
Yeah, from 10 to 12.
10 to 12 today, an opportunity for you to meet Gordon Jump. We're going to talk about and reminisce a bit about KRP in just a moment.
This is Fred and Andy.
Come on. AM60 CKCL 721 with Dave Guy and actor Gordon Jump, Arthur Carlson, the station manager of WKRP, and, of course, Old Lonely, the Maytag repairman. He's in Truro this morning. You'll be able to meet him later this morning at the Warehouse Outlet. But we're delighted he's in our studio with us this morning, talking about Old Lonely and reminiscing about WKRP.
It's always fun to reminisce about WKRP.
What character was easiest for you as an actor to play off?
They're both pretty fun. Arthur Carlson, I think, probably was the easiest.
Mm-hmm.
Old Lonely is you walk a very fine line with him, mm-hmm. as in a way you did with Arthur Carlson. But I think probably Arthur was the most fun. I could do things with Arthur that I wouldn't do with Old Lonely.
How about working off another actor, doing scenes? Who was easiest for you to relate to?
Oh, those people on that show were so good that any time you got to work with any one of them, it was amazing, Dave. Sometimes, you know, as an actor, you have a trouble kind of getting a handle emotionally on a portion of the script.
Mm-hmm.
And we were such a tight-knit group, there was no feeling of threat from any of the other actors. I could go to Howard Hess when I would ask him. I said, watch this scene I'm doing with Bailey. There's something missing in it, and maybe you can help me get a handle on it. And he would watch the scene and say, Gordon, why don't you think about so-and-so and so-and-so? That's a great idea. And he would feel the same freedom, I think, to come to me, and we would share back and forth like that. It was a great cooperation with a group of people that worked 110% of the time. 110%, 100% of the time.
Actors always have, I'd seen as athletes, superstitions and so on. Did Les Nessman ever do a scene without a Band-Aid?
No, and you know why he did it. You hit it right on the head, Dave. It was a superstition. He, in the pilot that we did, walked into a low-hanging light with what we call barn doors on him. Somebody rehung the light, and he ran out of the scene and right on the head.
Wow.
Had to send him over to the infirmary to get stitches. They didn't have a doctor there to do the stitching, so they pulled it together with a butterfly, which is a Band-Aid
right.
type of suture. And then he put a Band-Aid over that. And as he was doing the show, he says, you know, if this pilot works and it goes to network, he says, I'm going to find a way to wear a Band-Aid in every show we do. And he did.
Oh, I watched every week just to find out where that darn Band-Aid was going to be. I thought it was a great bit.
We never got to tell the story, actually, about him. We came close to it once when we did a show in his home, and his pet dog attacks him all the time. It's the only guy I know that goes out with one of these big arm covers just to feed the dog because the dog made an attack on him. But Les was the kind of guy that on the weekend, this mild-mannered reporter, would go skydiving, race automobiles, motorcycles, all those things on his weekend. And he'd come in on Monday morning all bunged up with scratches and cuts, abrasions, and contusions. But we never got a chance to really bring that out in the script.
What show do you feel had the biggest impact on your audience? What episode of KRP had the impact on the audience?
I think probably impact-wise, the Who concert.
You bet.
We explained to the country, to the world, what festival seating was all about and the dangers that were inherent with that type of seating arrangement, where first come, first serve, and those kids rushing in there when the doors flip open to get as close to that band as they possibly can. I think for pure comedy, the show that has probably... it's just fallen into the Comedy Hall of Fame. It was the turkey drop, the Thanksgiving promotion. 20-some minutes lead up to one line. God is my witness, I thought turkeys could fly.
My favorite was the baseball game, got to tell you that.
Oh, and that is for a lot of people, particularly people whose parents forced them to play an instrument as opposed to do something else with their life, and trying to create musical creativity in all of us. My parents did that with a piano. I've never touched a piano since.
What issues do you feel, because WKRP dealt more with staff situations as opposed to the issues of the day to a large extent, would it be tackling major issues today, and if so, which ones?
I think it would take a look at the political scene. I think we'd have a tough time dealing with political correctness, this phenomenon that's, I don't know if it's in Canada, but in the United States, you got to watch what you say and how
yes,
you
sir.
Say it about who, which I think is all ridiculous.
Boy, does that bring us to a topic.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Lonnie Anderson, are you in her book? They took out the juiciest parts, I understand.
I haven't read the book. I do know from many friends that Gary Sandy's in that book, and I didn't realize all that stuff was going on.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's kind of exciting.
what else are you involved with these days besides All Lonely?
Well, I do some teaching. I do a little writing. I'm out and about, of course, for Maytag, not really as lonely as I might appear to be, because I have a chance to travel all over the United States and Canada for Maytag. Do a lot of work for the Leukemia Broadcasting Society in the States, and a few other organizations that deal with catastrophic children's diseases. And so I'm really hustling around all the time.
Now, Arthur Carlson lived in Cincinnati. Old Loney's based in Newton, Iowa. Where's home for Gordon Chum?
Costa Mesa, California. It is now. I actually grew up in a little town called Centerville, Ohio. They didn't know this when they hired me. Funny thing, Gary, about 6 weeks into the the show. Gary was had a few minutes aside from his scene, and I said, Gary, where did you grow up? And he said, oh, hell, he says, nobody knows, so I just tell him Dayton, Ohio. I said, what? I said, you're from where? Dayton. And I said, where are you really from? He said, well, Kettering. It's a little town outside. I started to laugh. He said, what's so funny? I said, we grew up 7 miles apart. I'm from Centerville. You're from Kettering. We used to scrimmage you in football. He said, I never played football. I said, I was on the wrestling team. But he said, I can't believe that. My cousin then later sends me a picture of his first grade class. Here's my cousin sitting next to Gary Sandy on a bench when they took the photograph. Little things like this made you really suspect about who was putting that show together and at what level.
Incredible. Folks, you can meet Gordon Jump this morning from 10 to 12 noon at the Warehouse Outlet, corner of Glenwood and Willow. He's not going to disappoint you. You look great.
Thanks.
You look absolutely wonderful.
You do, too. You know, you're the best-dressed morning man I've ever seen in my life.
Hey, I'm getting out of here on a cue like that. Gordon, thank you. Very generous of you. Have a super day in Truro.
Thank you. Fun to be with you, Dave.
Funny and...